and all gathered here. On this blessed day, I take the privilege to extend a warm welcome to our dear reverend sisters, respected parents, staff and students, to celebrate God's wonderful gift to each one of us, our dear children. We celebrate Children's Day on the 14th of November as a tribute to our first Prime Minister, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, who was born this day in 1889. He shared an affectionate bond with children and was fondly called Chacha Nehru. He believed that children are the future of our nation and hence have to be nurtured and educated well. A famous quote of his says, "The children of today will make the India of tomorrow. The way we bring them up will determine the future of the country." Thus, wishing all our children good health, happiness, and success, we start today's proceedings with the lighting of the lamp. And children, may this light continue to kindle knowledge and wisdom to all the children, the past, the present, and the future of St. Teresa's family. May I now request Reverend Sister Lali, our Vice Principal, to garland the portrait of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Please, Sister. Thank you, Sister. The Lord said, "Let the children come to me, for theirs is the kingdom of God." Every child represents the image and likeness of God. On this special day, let's entrust each of our dear children to God's providence and grace that they may be filled with the abundant blessings of God. May I now invite our dear sisters and teachers to invoke the Almighty's blessing on each and every one of us. Please.
Amen.
form of communication that depicts the innermost feelings of the mind and the soul to the divine. We now have the welcome dance performed by Madam Udayashri. Please. That was indeed an elegant performance. Each child is a gift of God in his own image. Children in their innocence symbolizes God's very presence. To us, children are the very reason of our being. They are the bundle of our joy, life, hope, blessing, and the future of the nation. May I now invite Reverend Sister Roseman to give the message of the day. Please, sister.
Children are like buds in a garden and should be carefully and lovingly nurtured, as they are the future of the nation and the citizens of tomorrow. Only through right education can a better order of society be built up, says Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Dear Sister Mary Jyothi, the correspondent of the school, Sister Lalipol, the vice principal of the school, my dear staff, students and parents, warm greetings to everybody. On this awesome day, I am extremely glad to wish a very happy Children's Day to all our beloved students of St. Teresa School, Arul Colony. We miss you all a lot in the school, but being safe at home is the need of the hour. So take all the precautions against COVID-19 and be healthy. We pay homage to Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, a great lover of children and the first Prime Minister of India, whose birth anniversary we commemorate on this day. We celebrate and rejoice because children are the precious gifts God has gifted to us. On this beautiful day, I would like to tell you a story. As I know, as children, all of you love to listen to stories. Many, many years ago, there was once a swordsmith, S-W-O-R-D, sword. We say blacksmith, goldsmith, so swordsmith, that was known worldwide by his reputation for creating swords of unparalleled quality. People revered this man. He was the greatest master of his craft in the world. One day, a great king had heard about this swordsmith and wanted to meet him, no matter the cost. So the king's people went out and found this swordsmith in a very distant and small village, and they brought the swordsmith to meet the king. The swordsmith came in and was very humbled to get the opportunity to meet the king. The king in return was also very gracious and welcoming. Then the king asked the swordsmith his favorite question when he would meet a master. He said, "Swordsmith, what is the secret to your extraordinary excellence at what you do?" The swordsmith said, "It is very simple, my king. Ever since I was a young child, I was exposed to the craft of making swords. I fell in love with it. It did not only speak to my head and my logic, it spoke to me at the deepest and soulful level. I made a decision that I would be the master swordsmith. So I grew up, I read books on sword crafting, and if something did not relate to sword crafting, if it did not have the word sword in it, if it did not look like a sword, if it had nothing to do with the art of sword crafting, I did not spend my time with it. That is the secret of my mastery." Dear children, the great thinker and writer Emerson says, "What you think, you become." This means what we read, reflect, focus on will make us accordingly. If you read positive, you become a positive person. If you read and think negative, you become a negative person. If you think only on God, you will see God's presence everywhere. The one who reads, thinks, and visualizes demons or evil will only see demons even in his or her dreams. Decide which skill you wish to master and then focus on it. Do not let the ups and downs of the learning process distract you from your goal. Be positive always and be focused on God. If you want to become a musician, practice music regularly. If you want to be a professional, concentrate on professional growth. If you want to be an educationist, read good books and theories on education. If you want to be a spiritual person, spend your time on spiritual things. By focusing on many things, you end up mastering none. The key to mastering a skill is to know how to say no to things that do not get you closer to your goal. The choice is yours. This year, it's a coincidence that Diwali festival falls on 14 November, so we have double reason to celebrate this great day. Every child is potentially the light of the world. Let's wish and pray that may these little lamps burn brightly and become beacons of light, love, and service for generations to come. Dear children, wish you all a very happy Diwali. May the celebration of this festival of lights light up our lives, giving us true peace and joy. God bless you all. Have an amazing day. Thank you.
Words of wisdom are the lamps to our path. Thank you, dear sister, for the inspiring message. We wish that each children of us would work diligently pursuing their dreams for the future, the best that the master artist, the Lord, has set aside for them. May I now invite Master Suman to share his words of wisdom on this special day.
Adarniya Pradhanacharya, Uppradhanacharya, Sahyogi Acharya, एवं अभिभावक तथा प्यारे बच्चों, जैसा कि आप जानते हैं, हम लोग यहाँ पर बाल दिवस मनाने के लिए इकट्ठा हुए हैं। 14 नवंबर हर वर्ष बाल दिवस के रूप में मनाया जाता है। 1898 में पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू जी का जन्म हुआ था और उसी दिन से ये प्रथा शुरू हो गई थी कि हम बच्चों के उनके जन्मदिन पर जो है बाल दिवस मनाएं। पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू जी ने भारत के उत्थान के लिए बहुत परिश्रम और मेहनत की और देश के उज्जवल भविष्य को बनाया। आप जानते हैं कि वो पंडित जवाहरलाल नेहरू जी जो है भारत के प्रथम प्रधानमंत्री रह चुके हैं। हमें उनका आभार प्रकट करना चाहिए कि उन्होंने हमें इतना उज्जवल भविष्य दिया है। पंडित नेहरू जी अपने जन्मदिन को बाल दिवस के रूप में इसलिए मनाते हैं क्योंकि उनका कहना है कि देश का भविष्य उनके बच्चों पर केंद्रित होता है। सो बच्चों के भविष्य को उज्जवल बनाने के लिए उनके शारीरिक, मानसिक और शिक्षा विषय से संबंधित सभी चीज़ों को आवश्यक रूप से और ज़रूरी चीज़ों को उपलब्ध कराने के लिए जो है ये बाल दिवस उन्होंने मनाना शुरू किया। उन्होंने निश्चय किया कि उनका जन्मदिन जो है बाल दिवस के रूप में मनाया जाए। पंडित जी को सभी बच्चे जो है चाचा कहकर पुकारते थे। पंडित जी उन्हें बहुत पसंद करते थे और जब कभी भी उनका जन्मदिन होता या 14 नवंबर को जब उनका जन्मदिन होता तो उनके साथ बच्चे बनकर जो है उनका मन बहलाते थे। आप जानते हैं इस दिन जो है स्कूल और विद्यालय और संस्थानों में जो है तरह तरह के सजावटें की जाती है, बच्चों से संबंधित कई कार्यक्रम किए जाते हैं, जैसे भाषण प्रतियोगिता, निबंध लेखन, चित्रलेखन, रंगोली तो प्राय होती ही है और उसमें जो जितने भी प्रतियोगी भाग लेते हैं उनको विशेष रूप से सम्मानित किया जाता है। मैं सभी देश के माता पिता से ये प्रार्थना करना चाहता हूँ कि वह अपने बच्चों को ढेर सारा प्यार और आशीष दे। आज बच्चों का जीवन तनावग्रस्त है, बच्चे तनाव में उलझे हुए हैं, उन्हें तनाव मुक्त जीवन दीजिए, उन्हें फलने फूलने का अवसर दीजिए, उनकी ज़रूरतों की चीज़ें जैसे शारीरिक मानसिक विकास में उपलब्ध जो भी चीज़ें हैं उन्हें उपलब्ध कराइए, उन्हें ऐसा भविष्य निर्माण करने के लिए अवसर दीजिए ताकि जो है वह हमारे देश की प्रगति में सहायक हो सकें। आगे मैं अपने शिक्षक दल से भी यही प्रार्थना करना चाहता हूँ कि वह हमारे बच्चों को उनके सोचने तथा कार्य करने की शक्ति को और उसमें बदलाव लाने के लिए ऐसे कदम उठाएं और ऐसी शिक्षा दें ताकि वो अपने भविष्य का निर्माण सही ढंग से कर सकें। उज्जवल भविष्य पाने के लिए जो है हमारे शिक्षकों का सबसे बड़ा कर्तव्य है कि वो अपने बच्चों को ऐसी सोच और ऐसी कार्य शक्ति दें जिससे कि जो है वो अपने भविष्य का निर्माण सही ढंग से कर सकें। जैसे जवाहरलाल नेहरू जी ने हमारे देश को आज़ाद करवाया या आज़ादी में सहयोग दिया और जो है आज़ाद भारत का निर्माण किया। उन्होंने, आप जानते ही हैं कि बांध बनाए, कई बांध ऐसे बनाए, प्रगति के क्षेत्र में काफ़ी कार्य किया। सो हमारे भी बच्चे जब आगे बड़े हों तो उनको जो है उज्जवल भविष्य प्राप्त होगा, वो एक अच्छे सफल इंजीनियर, डॉक्टर, पत्रकार, उद्योगपति तथा अन्य क्षेत्र में जो है उन्नति करें। आगे मैं बच्चों के लिए चाहता हूँ, दो पंक्तियाँ मैंने लिखी है उनके लिए, वो पढ़कर आपको सुना देता हूँ। तो तुम हो देश का भविष्य, देश संभाले रखना। बच्चों तुम हो देश का भविष्य, देश संभाले रखना। लगन श्रद्धा और ईमानदारी से चमन संभाले रखना। लगन श्रद्धा और ईमानदारी से चमन संभाले रखना। ज़रूरत नहीं हिंसा की, ज़रूरत नहीं हिंसा की, अहिंसा भी मार्ग है। ज़रूरत नहीं हिंसा की, अहिंसा भी मार्ग है। पथ पर चलते चलते तुम ये बात याद रखना, बच्चों तुम हो देश का भविष्य, देश को उज्जवल बनाए रखना। थैंक यू, धन्यवाद। मैं चाहता हूँ कि अपने सहयोगी मित्र जिन्होंने मुझे ये अवसर दिया, प्रधानाचार्य, उप प्रधानाचार्य, सहयोगी प्रधानाचार्य और अभिभावकों का नमन करता हूँ कि उन्होंने मुझे ये सुंदर अवसर प्रदान किया ताकि मैं बाल दिवस पर दो शब्द कह सकूँ। धन्यवाद।
थैंक यू मास्टर फॉर द मूविंग एंड मोटिवेशनल स्पीच। इट्स ऑल्सो एन इंस्पिरेशन फॉर अस पेरेंट्स टू ब्रिंग फोर्थ आर चिल्ड्रन इन द पाथ ऑफ पीस एंड प्रॉस्पेरिटी एज वेल। Now, we have our dear teachers performing a dance for our children. Teachers for the beautiful performance. Thank you master for the moving and motivational speech. It's also an inspiration for us parents to bring forth our children in the path of peace and prosperity as well. May I now request Sunita teacher to share few words of inspiration for our children. Thank you. Please teacher. May I now request Sunita teacher to share few words of inspiration for our children. Thank you.
Good evening everyone present here. Every child is a different kind of flower, and all together make this world a beautiful garden. A very happy Children's Day to all my dear students. Today is a very special day as we celebrate Children's Day, a day dedicated to all the children, the precious angels. This day is celebrated to mark the birth anniversary of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, the first Prime Minister of our country. His two favorite things were children and roses. He loved children a lot, and as a token of respect and love, it was decided to celebrate Children's Day on 14th November every year. The day highlights the significance of giving love, attention, and affection to children. This special day reminds all of us to nurture and provide a pure childhood to all the children, to uphold the dignity of the child, save them from exploitation and other social evils in the society, and give them access to rightful education. Nehru strongly believed that educating and empowering the youth is essential to have a developed India. Children are the invaluable assets of the nation. Love, affection, and opportunities can help in getting the students educated and increase the country's economy. Nation blossoms when children blossom. My dear children, I would like to remind you that all of you are future leaders, nation builders, and the hope of our country. The strength of a country is the children of the country. You must shoulder the responsibility to work towards a better society, a better India, and be instruments to bring about transformation in the country. Think and work for the motherland with a spirit of dedication. Dear friends, let us remember Nehru's message to provide a safe and loving environment to our children, giving them ample opportunities to take great strides and contribute to the progress of the nation. Once again, I extend my warmest greetings and wishes to all us students on Children's Day. Thank you.
Each child of ours is an innocent, beautiful, and graceful rose, and together you make up the garden of St. Teresa. We now have a dance performance by our teachers as a tribute to our children on this day. For the elegant performance. As a tribute to the innocence of our children, We now have our dear teachers presenting a melody. Considered children as roses. As long as the child is in the childhood, the child is protected both by the family and by the school. Child has not seen the thorns in life. May every child of the St. Teresa's family have no thorns in their lives, but only the beauty and softness, the peace, health and joy of the roses, built upon by their success and hard work. This day reminds us of our motive towards the upliftment of our children and to work together to bring up them into a healthy new generation. There can be no better day than today to acknowledge the hard work and success of our children in bringing pride to both the family and the school.